Hello and welcome to Taboratum channel. As you may remember, few episodes back I was designing and printing a coffee dripper and the plastic that I used was not enough heat resistant. So I mentioned that I will look for one that will be strong enough, and actually I did. I've done some online research and decided to go for the colorFabb PLA-HP filament, and HP stands for high performance. This filament has 134 degrees HDT. HDT is heat deflection temperature, so temperature at which the plastic starts to change its shape. It's not cheap, as you can see, it's a bit more expensive than regular PLA. And obviously there are some disadvantages because it is supposed to be warping more than the regular PLA. So I've ordered it, and here it is. So let's do some real life testing. As a frugal 3D printer, I decided to put my design on diet to save some of the expensive filament. And so it's now just 1 millimeter thick, and these flaps are super tiny and use minimal amount of filament. So let's see how this performs. I start brewing. And initially everything looked nice and easy, and yeah, I drank the coffee afterwards and it was delicious and didn't taste PLA. However, being too frugal was not helpful. The thing didn't get destroyed, but it will get soft enough to collapse. Of course, I managed to save the coffee, but let's see how the device looks afterwards. It's still one piece each, but it is a bit bent and the flaps are definitely too thin, as you can see here. But let's say that it's yet another proof of concept done, and I believe that if I would print it in 2 millimeters or maybe even 2.5, it will work fine. So now let's move to the other test. You can see that the water is boiling, and here is the container that I've printed, single layer vase mode. And yeah, the temperature of print was too high, but let's see if it's what heat resistant. We have boiling water poured into this single walled container, 3D printed. And you see, yes, it is watertight. And yes, it is heat resistant, so it's boiling watertight, we can say. What actually happens is that the walls softened a bit, but they still keep the shape. So it proves the point. I've also printed a tea light holder. Honestly, usually you can get away with the PLA, but 134 degrees resistance is definitely better, and you can be more safe with your tea light. Now let's talk a bit about the filament itself. As it has different properties than regular PLA, we can easily see that it warps more like ABS. You can see the bottom of this first try was not flat at all. So what I used a Dimafix glue on my build plate. So the next print was fine and flat at the bottom. As I noticed some artifacts on the side of this container, I decided to do a proper print temperature test. So I've printed this super simple temperature test, and then I checked if the print is strong enough, so I broke it. But you can basically see that at temperature closer to 230, 220, there's a lot of stringing, and the decent temperature for this filament is around 190 degrees, at least on my printer. Please let me know if you have any ideas where such a filament might be applied. Leave it in the comments, subscribe, and thanks for watching. See you soon. Bye bye.